Call the cards. Don't be rash. If you're right, you'll win the cash on Card Sharks. And here's the host of Card Sharks, Jim Perry.
Thank you. Terrific end of week audience. Thank you for being here. Thank you for joining us. You're delightful. Thank you. Our poem, a very good poem, sent in by... Hello there. What is this? We got a choir on. That's terrific. Justine Whitetrack of Saratoga, New York, sent in that poem. Thank you, Justine. We have a game in progress right now. We're starting game number two of a best 2 out of 3 match, so let's get to the cards. Janice and Ann, if you will, load in the cards. Same two decks of cards we played the first game with, and we'll meet our players on Card Sharks. Hello there. Kathy Doty. Hi, Kathy. Would you remind us about yourself?
My name is Kathy Doty. I am a first grade teacher, and I live in Mission Viejo, and I enjoy most sports, especially volleyball and skiing and tennis.
How are the first graders to teach? Are they good?
They're a challenge.
Yeah, that's good way of putting it, Kathy. A challenge, yes.
Very, very much.
And our challenger, this is Larry Levy.
Hi,
hello, Larry.
Jim, how
nice
you
to meet you. Would you tell us about yourself?
I'm a sales manager for a major publishing company. I play tennis, a little bit of racquetball, make some stained glass windows, and I'm a gourmet cook.
Gourmet cook. Okay.
Uh-oh.
Gourmet cook.
Right.
What did you cook for dinner last night?
I knew you were going to ask me. I ate out.
You ate out.
I ate out.
Good luck to both of
Thank you.
Each player has his or her own deck of 52 playing cards, shuffled and cut before we go in the air. Kathy, the champion, plays the upper cards, the red cards. Kathy is a challenger, and so is Larry. I forgot we retired a champion. We have two challengers. Kathy plays the red. Larry plays the blue. Before he can begin to call the cards, you must first win a high-low toss-up question. As we left off, Kathy, the question goes to you. Remember, best 2 out of 3. Larry won game number one. You need this game, Kathy. Yeah, now, you know, Robert Redford is considered as a great sex symbol, right?
Mm-hmm.
So we asked 100 women, would you be turned on by a nude centerfold of Robert Redford? How many women said they would be turned on?
Oh, I think he really is a big sex symbol. I think I'd say 75.
75 women would be turned on by a nude centerfold of Robert Redford.
I think a lot of women like Robert Redford, but I'm not sure they'd be turned on by a centerfold. They might be disappointed. I'd say it's lower.
Do you have any inside information we should know about?
No, okay. I don't.
The actual number of women who would be turned on by a nude centerfold of Robert Redford is 18. Oh. Very much lower. Larry, wow.
All right, okay.
Well,
make it a good one.
Your base card is a 5.
5.
You can change it if you'd like. You won the question.
Change it. I want to change it.
And you
give
must
me a good
play
one.
This one.
All
a great
right!
change
See,
to an ace.
I knew. Lower. The next one's lower.
Lower than an ace. Yes, that's an 9.
I'm going to freeze. I'll freeze it.
Move the freeze bar over. Can't take those cards away from you. And, of course, you've kept Kathy away from her cards. Larry, we polled 100 people in Plains, Georgia, President Carter's hometown. We asked them, if Jimmy Carter ran for re-election tomorrow, would you vote for him? How many people in Plains, Georgia said they would vote for Jimmy Carter?
Well, that's really difficult. I don't know how many registered Democrats there are and how many relatives
As
he
I
has.
As I recall from the past show, there are less than 400 people in
that's
Plains,
right.
Georgia, so we polled 100 of them. We got most of them.
I would say 65.
65 said they'd vote for Jimmy Carter, Kathy.
I think he's a favorite son candidate, and I think... Now, this is just in Plains, Georgia, right?
Plains,
in
Georgia.
This city. I'm going to say higher.
You say higher than
right.
65 would vote
right.
for Jimmy Carter. The actual number of people in Plains, Georgia who would vote for Jimmy Carter is 57, not higher. Larry. Wow.
Change it. And make it a good one. Another
right
ace.
To change the 9. And
oh,
he goes to a queen.
All right. I say it's lower.
Lower than a queen. Oh, no. It's an ace. Not lower. And good thing you froze there. We can't take you back any further than that. Kathy, you'll play a 7. You didn't win the question. You have to play it.
Okay, I'm going to 7 isn't a very good card, but I'm going to say higher.
Higher than a 7. Yes, for the big ace.
Oh, great. Okay, I need this game. I'm going to say lower.
Lower than an ace. It is a 4,
great,
very much lower.
And that's a great card. I'm going to go higher.
Higher than a 4? No, it's a 2. And you lose all 3 cards back to the base card. And Janice fills in the space as we go to the next question to you, Kathy.
Okay.
We asked 100 window washers who work on skyscrapers in New York City, have you ever fallen off your scaffold? How many window washers had fallen off the scaffold?
I don't know. I know years ago my grandfather was a window washer, and they used to have accidents all the time, but I'm going to say 35.
35 have fallen off the scaffold, Larry.
I don't think you'd have very many window washers left if 35 had fallen off. I'll say it's lower.
You say lower.
Lower.
The actual number of window washers who'd fallen off a scaffold and lived to tell about it is 11. It's lower, Larry.
Okay.
Yes.
I'll try it again, and I'll say that it's lower.
Yeah, 11. That'll teach them to step back and admire their work.
Lower.
Larry, you've got a queen.
Make it
you're
a good one.
And you say lower.
Lower. Lower.
Lower than the queen.
Oh,
yes, it's
all
a 10.
Right. All right. I'm going to freeze.
You'll freeze.
I'm going to freeze.
Why are you freezing there, Larry?
I have my reasons.
Uh-huh.
I'll tell you later.
Could it possibly be that we have sudden
death
coming up?
Yes.
Someone has to win on this play of the cards. Larry, we asked 100 people, do you believe the Loch Ness Monster really exists? How many people said yes?
Oh, my gosh. No one's seen it, but I tend to believe that it exists. I would say 38.
38 people said the Loch Ness Monster
yes
exists, Kathy.
Wow, that's really tough. There have been people who have seen it, and I know there's been pictures taken of it. I'm going to say higher.
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 The actual number of people who believe the Loch Ness Monster exists is 35, not higher. And again, Larry has control.
That's dynamite.
Now, Larry, with sudden
yes
death, you have a 10.
Yes.
You have the right to change it and try to turn these two cards over. But
oh,
if you make a mistake, Kathy wins. However, you can force Kathy to play off the 7. She cannot change it. She would have to turn all 4 cards over to win. Your decision. Play it or pass it.
Being a gentleman, I'm going to pass
it. You're going to pass it.
Yes.
Okay.
Kathy, you've got a 7. If you can turn 4 cards over, we've got a tie. If you make one mistake, Larry wins the championship and goes to the money cards. Call this.
Okay. I'm going to say higher.
Higher than a 7.
It's got to be higher.
It is.
Oh,
it's a queen.
Great. Oh, that keeps me alive. I'm going to say lower.
Lower.
Lower
than a queen. Yes.
Great.
It's a 6. Halfway there.
Oh, a 6 is a terrible, terrible card. I'm going to say higher.
Higher than a 6. Yes,
oh,
it's a
great
10. One to go.
Okay, now 10 is tough. I'm going to say lower. Lower,
this is lower.
Please.
We've got a tie. If not,
lower.
Larry wins it.
Yes!
She did it with 4 cards. Tying on the match. Great comeback. We're tied 1-1. We'll play the tiebreaker right after this. Got a good match going, and Kathy with 1 game, Larry with 1 game, and now let's get set up for the tiebreaker with just 3 cards up there and 3 questions here. And the question as we left off goes to you, Kathy. We asked 100 people, if your neighbor's magazines were put in your mailbox by mistake, would you keep them or return them? How many people admitted they would keep them?
I don't know. If my neighbor's magazines were put in mine, I would take it over to their house and give it to them.
Isn't that nice?
I know. I'm a very good neighbor. I would say 15.
15
say really
would
low
keep them.
15 would keep them.
What do you
them
think, Larry?
I will admit to keeping some magazines. I'd say it's higher.
You say higher?
Yeah.
The actual number of people who said they would keep their neighbor's magazines rather than return them is 22.
All
it's
right
higher, Larry.
Okay.
And that
make it a good one
base card. Is it 9? Do you want it?
I want to change it. Give me a good one. Come on.
Here it is.
An 8.
Ooh.
Oh,
tough card
gosh
to start with, Larry. Call this.
I say it's higher. I think it's higher.
Higher than an 8?
Yes, hey! All right. All right. It's got to be lower.
You're going to go for
it's
it.
It's got to be lower.
If
make
this
it
is
lower,
lower, we have a new
make
champion.
Make it lower.
No, it's not lower. It's another 10. And Kathy, you're still alive with
A 9.
Got to play it,
okay,
Kathy.
Okay, I'm going to say I'm going to say it's lower.
Lower. Lower than a 9. Yes,
oh,
that's
great
a 7.
Okay, I'm going to say it's Should I freeze? I'm going to say it's higher.
Got to go for
higher
it.
Higher. Go for
the
for
win.
It all.
Higher than a 7.
Yeah.
She did it. Congratulations, Kathy. Larry, right down to
great
the line. Good
thank
match.
You.
And of course,
lot
you got $100 at some party. Just
thank
here
you, Larry.
Thank you. Kathy, come on down here. You were thinking of freezing on that 7.
No, I knew I was going to come back.
Thank you. I hope she wins a lot of money on the money cards coming up right after this. We're back with Kathy Doty, our new champion. Kathy, you said this is your lucky blouse?
Right. I wore this to all the interviews. Every time I've played a game in this blouse, I've won.
Well, I hope you're going to do very well right now. Let's open the board and get to the money cards. Come on, Kathy, let's have the blouse bring you lots of good luck. You won $200 in the game, yours to keep. Now we've got a brand new deck of cards for you, all shuffled and cut, and we're going to give you new money to play with, and this time you're going to bet that money. As you start on the bottom line, we'll give you $200 and 3 cards. When you move up to the second level, we add another $200 of betting money, and we give you 3 more cards. Your minimum bets are $50 till you get to the top card, the big bet. There you must bet at least half the money.
Right.
Let's get that lucky blouse working and $200.
Okay.
Okay, Kath, here's that important base card to get you started. It is a
jack.
Oh, Jack,
I'm going to keep it. I'm going to go $200 lower.
Right away, the whole thing.
Go
$200
for it.
Lower than a jack. It is.
Oh,
it's a 7.
Okay.
You've doubled your money to 400.
7 isn't that great a card. I'm going to go $100 higher.
$100 higher than a 7. It's
yes!
a queen.
Oh,
you're up to 500,
okay.
Kathy.
I've got 500. I'm going to go all of it lower. All of it lower.
$500 lower than a queen. Oh, no.
That's okay. I've got my 200 up
Yeah,
there.
But you're still in it because you've only busted on the bottom level. As we bring the king up, we'll give you that other $200 of money, Kathy.
Okay,
you're back in it with a king.
I'm gonna play it kind of safe. I'm going to go $150 lower.
$150 lower than that king, and she's
got
it.
Okay.
Up to $350 again, building it back up with a 10, Kathy.
10, I'm going to go $150 lower.
$150 lower than a 10?
Oh,
yeah!
Okay.
Great card! A
I'm
going to
go 500 higher, all of it.
All of
it,
$500 higher than a 2.
Yeah!
Up to 1,000.
Oh, okay.
Limited.
I got to go.
Oh,
lower,
you don't want to know about the options,
lower,
everything.
Lower.
$1,000 lower than an ace. It is for $2,000. Great comeback. Okay, come on around here. That's terrific. Great comeback from that bust.
Oh, it's going to help. I just know I got it all spent already.
Oh, yes? What do you got to spend on?
Oh, my husband and I just bought a home last year, and there's so many things we want to do with it, and that's going right for that.
We're happy for you. That's terrific. We'll meet a new challenger right after this. Back with our champion, Kathy Doty. Kathy, you were telling me that $300 was a very important figure for you to win. Why is that?
Well, my husband is, we have a slope in our backyard. My husband's been building a retaining wall, and he got an estimate to dig out the hill to build a retaining wall, and it was $300. And he said, forget it. And he's been digging it out by hand with picks and shovels, and I just know his back is going to feel so much better.
Now you're going to give him a present.
Right. That's
going to
be his present.
That's
right.
Terrific. Good. Okay, Kathy, time to defend that title. Janice? Two brand new decks of cards, all shuffled and cut, and our next player on Card Sharks. Carol Phillips. Hello, Carol. Welcome.
Hi there.
Nice to have you here.
Nice to be here.
Would you tell us about yourself?
Yes. My name is Carol Phillips. I am formerly from Hawaii. I've been living in California for the past year. I am now working as a waitress and a secretary in Newport Beach.
Good. So you're doing two jobs,
yes.
Huh? Busy lady. What brought you from pretty Hawaii to pretty California?
Well, it goes like this. Rock fever, family, and boyfriend.
Oh, okay. In that order, right? Carol, nice to have you here. You'll play the lower cards, the blue cards. Kathy, the champion, plays the upper cards, the red cards. Kathy, our man on the street approached 100 people who were walking their dog and asked them, for $100, will you sell me your dog? How many dog owners were willing to sell their dog for $100?
I don't know. Most people really, you know, a dog is like part of the family. And I don't think it'd be very high. I'd say 15.
15.
Right.
Carol, higher or lower?
Oh, that's really a hard question. I would say if they have a dog and they're taking the time to walk it, they will not sell it. I'll have to say it's lower.
You say lower.
Yes.
Of course, I seem to recall that some people a while ago were willing to paint their dog blue. Let's find out how many would sell it. The actual number of dog owners who were willing to sell their dog for $100 to a total stranger is 38. It's not lower, Kathy. I don't know what they're walking out there. Kathy, your base card is a king.
Oh, it's great. I'm going to keep it, and I'm going to go lower.
Lower than a king? Yes,
great.
It's a nine.
Okay, I'm going to... That's a terrible card. I'm going to freeze right
freezing
there.
It right there.
Well, I'm here.
Getting three cards to Carol's four. And the first question to you, Carol. We asked 108th grade girls, which would you rather do, win the Miss America pageant or become the first female astronaut to walk on the moon? How many 8th grade girls would rather win the Miss America pageant?
Oh, with all the benefits you get with the Miss America pageant, I would think it would be pretty high. But I'll have to go right down the middle and say 50.
50, she says, Kathy, putting the pressure to you, higher or lower?
I don't know. It seems to me like with women's living and everything, they have a lot less emphasis on beauty contests and everything. This is a tough one. I think...
I'm ready.
I'm just going to say higher.
You're going to say higher. More would rather be Miss America.
I'm going to regret it, but I'm going to say higher.
The actual number of 8th grade girls who would rather be Miss America than the first female astronaut is... 69. That's higher. Kathy.
Okay.
Wow.
I'm going to change the card. I don't want that card.
Now you can change the 9 to an 8.
Oh, that's not much better. Ooh. I'm going to say... Lower.
Lower than an 8? Oh, no, it's an 8. The time for an ace to come up. Carol, a break for you. You play a 2.
Good card. Great card. I'll go higher.
Higher than a 2. Yes, with a jack.
A jack is a good card. I'll have to continue and go lower.
Lower than a jack? No, it's a king. Couldn't advance and take advantage of it. We go to question 3. Kathy, we polled 100 women executives across the country. Now, these women are all vice presidents of corporations. We asked them, if your company wanted to send you on a year-long business trip around the world, but your husband had to stay home, would you go anyway? How many women executives said they would go on that year-long trip?
I don't know. That's a once-in-a-lifetime deal, but I don't know. I think most women still hold their family to be very close. I know I wouldn't do it. I'm going to say, I think it's going to be pretty low. I'd say 9.
9, Carol, higher or lower?
With women's live and how women love to travel, I have to say it is higher.
Higher. The actual number of women executives who would go on a year-long business trip without their husbands is 31. It's higher. Carol. Yeah, they're executives. Look at the 2, Carol.
We'll keep that 2, Jim, and we'll go higher.
Higher than a 2? Yeah,
yes!
With a big ace.
Yes! Lower.
Lower than an ace? It is with a 4.
To continue and go higher.
Okay, risking those 2 cards in this one, higher than a 4, yes, with a jack.
Yes, yes.
Now, big decision, 1 card to go.
Here we go. We're going to risk them. We're going lower.
You're
going
to risk it. If this is lower than a jack, you've got the first game of the match for the win. Yes, he did it with a 3. And game number 1 to the challenger. Let's quickly set up for game 2. So the pressure is now on the champion. Kathy, you need this game, and the first question in the game goes to Carol as we set up with the next cards off the top of the deck. Carol, we asked 100 married women, if your husband were at a nude beach where everyone was lying face down and wearing large beach hats, could you pick him out of the crowd? How many women said they could pick their husband out of a crowd?
Oh, I would think that a lot of women would think they could. But I would still say it would have to be pretty low. I'll say 35.
All right, Kathy, higher or lower?
I don't know. That's pretty difficult. I'm going to say lower.
Lower than that.
Lower,
I can just picture them all laying out there. That looks ridiculous.
The
actual number of married women who said if their husband were lying face down at a nude beach, they could pick him out of the crowd is 80, not lower. You got it. Carol, your base card is a 9. You want it?
Change it, please.
Changing it to an 8. Oh. Ooh, not a good change.
For some reason, something tells me higher.
Higher than an 8? No, it's a 3. Great for Kathy, who will be playing a king.
Oh, beautiful card. I'm going to go lower.
Lower than a king. It is a 2.
Oh, great, beautiful card. I'm going to go higher.
Higher than a 2? Yes,
another great card. I'm going to go lower.
Lower than a jack.
Yes,
right,
a 10.
Oh.
Okay, 10 is really a hard card.
What are you going to do?
I'm going to freeze.
She'll freeze it.
Freeze.
Kathy needs one card while Carol needs four, but Carol leads in the match. It is time for us to take time out for this commercial message. Thank you for joining us. We'll see you next time on Card Sharks. Bye-bye.
A representative of the studio audience will receive Skyway's newest luggage for easier handling on stairs, curbs, and tight places, upright luggage on wheels, outdoor twist fabric and colors, including new Fantasia, upright luggage on wheels furnished by Skyway. And some of our contestants will receive from Gallery of Homes a book on home improvements. Gallery of Homes brokers, if you're selling or buying a home, you'll find they do their homework. And the Maxipedic by Simmons, designed in cooperation with an orthopedic surgeon, features a built-in bedboard in the box spring for super comfort and support from Simmons. And from Kinney Shoes, the great American shoe store, an up-to-the-minute selection of fashion footwear. Kinney Shoes not only fit your feet, they fit your life. And through Day's rental of HR's portable steam carpet cleaning system with a supply of cleaning chemicals. HR Carpet Care Centers available in supermarkets. This is Gene Woods speaking for Card Sharks, a Mark Goodson, Bill Todman production.